Smart Reverb is a unique tool that quickly computes a tailored reverb for your audio material. Its revolutionary control options also allow you to create sounds that go beyond what you'd be able to accomplish with a regular reverb plugin. In this example, I want to add some character to this drum loop. I'll start out by choosing a profile and letting the plugin learn. I play around with the reverb matrix until I find a reverb style I'm happy with. I edit the spread curve to fine-tune my sound. I want my reverb to start out with a lot of stereo width. I'll then tighten it a little at the end of the reverb tail. These drums sound a little too muddy for me, so I'll take steps to clean them up. I set the mono below line to about 200 Hz. I'll add further clarity using the density curve. I start out with a moderate density and increase it over time. These settings combined with a higher clarity value will make my drum loop sound less muddy. I've already let Smart Reverb learn this guitar track. Now I will use the decay curve and spectral shaper grid to create a kind of reverse reverb effect. First, I choose a fairly long reverb time to get a harmonic sonic image. A decay curve that rapidly slopes down at the beginning and then rises again will fill in all the gaps in the guitar track and give that reversed feeling that I was talking about. Extending the reverb time in the highs using the spectral shaper grid will further emphasize the effect. Smart Reverb comes with two special settings that allow for some pretty spectacular reverb effects. Both will essentially stretch your reverb time infinitely, but in slightly different ways. While freeze captures the current reverb tail and repeats it continuously, infinite applies an endless reverb to the incoming signal. For this example, I've used Smart Reverb to quickly build a smooth transition from a pad into a drum track. With the reverb bypassed, the transition sounds a little dull and zaps the track's energy. I've set up my automation to engage freeze mode just before the short pause so that it has some audio input to work with. I've also automated my wet settings to have the reverb tail phase out softly. In this example, I've used Infinite and automated a high-pass filter in Smart Reverb's integrated EQ to build a rise. The infinite function does a great job of adding a mellow atmosphere to instrument tracks. In this case, I've added the Smart Reverb in infinite mode to a guitar track and played around with the dry wet values until my guitar line was still audible, but enriched with atmospheric sounds. Now I'm basically just one drum loop and some vinyl crackle short of a lo-fi beat you might want to relax and study to.